Hi, it's Somanimus. Today we're going to learn how to display your character emotions over their heads in 5 minutes. Let's go! First, you need to have all your animation sprites in the same format. In my case, that's 4 frames. Then we create a new folder in Scenes for our animations, and we create a new scene of type Node2D. This scene will contain our emotion animation, so name it accordingly. We need a Sprite2D, which will contain the sprite we want to animate. In our texture fields, just put any one of your sprites which will serve as a preview. Then set the H frames value to match the number of frames in your animation. Now let's create our animation player node. We create our animation by clicking animation, new, then we enter the name, animate in our case. Click our sprite2D, then the key next to frame course to link the first frame. After selecting the next frame in the timeline, we increment the coordinates, then click the key again. Let's do the same thing for our 2 remaining frames. Once done, we can click the play button to preview the animation. We can add a fade effect to our animation. Let's click visibility, modulate, and put the alpha to 0. Then click the key. A few frames later, we put the modulate alpha value to 1 and click the key again. At the end of our animation, let's do the opposite to make the sprite fade out. You can now click the play button to ensure that the animation plays properly. And if it does, let's create a script to play the animation. First, we want to declare our class name EmotionAnim. Then, we reference our nodes Sprite2D and AnimationPlayer. We also need to preload our animation sprites. In my case, I start with 2 sprites, one for love animation and one for interrogation animation. We create a private method which will make the animation player play the animation. Then we'll create one public function per animation. In my case, we want to play the love animation, so we set the texture to the love sprite. Then we play the animation. Same thing for interrogation, by setting the sprites to interrogation sprites. If you have an audio player, like the one we learned to make in our previous tutorial, you can preload your effects, love and interrogation, and play them in the corresponding functions. We also create a destroy function to remove our nodes after a given time. We'll wait for the time provided in arguments. Then we call Q3 to remove the node. We want to play the animations not only for our player, but also for the other characters, like the enemies. So let's create a common script, character. First, we want our script to extend character_body_2d, as it's the class used by both our player and our enemies. Then we declare our class name, character. We also need our emotion anim scene that we created previously. Let's now create a function to display our animation over our character's heads. It will take as parameter the time of the animation, then the offset on the x-axis, the offset on the y-axis, and it will return an object of type EmotionAnim. We create a new instance of our EmotionAnim scene by calling the instantiate function. Then we use addChild to add our instance as a child of our character node. We then call the destroy method after the given time, and we set the global position relatively to a character global position plus the offset in x and y axis. And we can return our instance. We'll create one function per animation with our time as parameter. Create our instance with our time and our offset values. For me it's 5 and minus 16, but you'll need to adjust depending on your sprite size. Now let's make our player and enemy class both extend our character. In order to test our animation, I'm going to write a temporary code in the process method. If the left key is pressed, we want to display the interrogation animation. If the right key is pressed, we want to display the love animation. Before testing, let's add an enemy in our scene. And that's it, you have your animation system working. You can extend this system to do other things like contextual actions. If this tutorial was useful to you, leave a like and subscribe to see more short tutorials like this one. See you soon!